Hey guys, what is up and welcome back to my channel. You guys, we are within a bear face. I am rocking a bear face. Now, it's been a very long time, the beginning of June, but I did film it prior to that. So I will be putting the date here. Now, it's been almost a full on month. Actually, yeah, no, it's been over a month since my skin was really bad, and I'm going to go ahead and link both of the videos up below so you guys can check it out. Check out my experience of what I did when it came to oil cleansing. Now, I probably didn't do the oil cleansing properly, but I feel that it was just that my pores got really clogged up. And it ended up giving me what's called acne fungal, but it's not, but it is, but it's... Anyways... My skin ended up getting lots of little tiny bumps, and I was stressing out, which wasn't good for my skin. It was just not good. Stressing out does not help your skin at all. It just makes it worse, and that's what I was doing because I was stressing out because I had really good skin. Like, my skin was going up and up and up, and for me to have it just crash down, hit me, it really, like, just brought me down a lot. I wasn't feeling well. It's an emotional roller coaster because I was really working hard on my skin. So for this to just completely just crash it down, it really impacted me differently. Now I know that there's a lot more bigger things in the world out there than my own skin. I know. But I just wanted to show you guys the things that I ended up using to clarify my skin, to help my skin out a little bit more. Now, I was actually thinking that I should go out and buy more stuff and just like do all this research and figure out how to get the fastest, the best. And one thing that I learned is patience when it comes to skin care. Now, there is no way that I'm going to wake up the next day with already my flawless skin back. I'm going to wake up with the most minimal. There's no way that was ever gonna happen. I basically had to have patience for this, and I'm a very impatient person. So I was really hoping that some product out there will immediately erase and remove and take off everything that I have, but there is no product out there that's willing to do that. So I wasn't gonna do a lot of online shopping for that, but then I started thinking about it. I was like, I have a lot of acne cleanse remover helping thinking majingis that are gonna help for my skin. Like, why not work with what I already have? Like, why go outside and spend more money? With that being said, let's get to the products that help me out with my skin. Now, we're gonna do a zoom because I want you guys to see how my skin is currently doing. Now that we're up close and personal, as you can see, I have like a big old, it's actually gone already. It was like a huge sit. So I have the leftover here, and I do have a lot of like little remaining bumps here. As you can see, I have a lot of acne stain marks, but I still do have a lot of the little bumps here and there. I have them especially in my chin area still and down here. And then I have them here as well. So this is like the largest patch that I'm struggling to kind of like minimize and remove. And then, of course, my nose, pores, no comment. So, my face isn't looking that terrible as it was when we first started, which I'm pretty happy. I am satisfied, but I'm still going to keep on going forward onto this. There's a few products that I'm actually looking forward to coming in that I bought that I've been reading a lot of good reviews of them. Let's go ahead and start with some products that I already had in my house that I didn't go out of my way to buy because I wanted to work with what I have at home, because I don't want to spend more money on acne products when I already have a crap load of acne products. Let's go ahead and start off with this one. I started washing my face with CeraVe facial cleansing from normal to oily skin. Now, I would recommend more of the SA, but I didn't end up buying it. I heard that one's actually better for your acne, but I bought this one. Well, actually, my little sister already had this one, and I saw her skin cleared up really good, and I heard that it has really good things, so I started using this to clean my face. Now, I do double cleanse my face, so I do use this one to clean my face, as well as I would use the Pixi Mud Cleanser to clean my face, and I would use these both AM and PM. This is my double cleansing method. Then I would go ahead and exfoliate my face because I would have a lot of whiteheads in my skin. I would double exfoliate as well. But I would rotate them as one day this one, another day that one. This one is a jelly glow peel. This is a gentle non-abrasive exfoliating. And this one is just a brightening scrub. That's all it is. It's not even an exfoliator, but I still consider this as an exfoliator because it has little beads. Now, this one is like really surprising because with this one, when I would use it, you just see immediately, like as soon as I will touch my face and just rub it once, all these little white stuff would come out. So my face had a lot of dead skin. Just a lot. I've never seen it this extreme. Something that I would use on a weekly basis is this baby right over here. Now, I have this one from Makeup Revolution as well, but I think they're not the same at all. So I just went ahead and I had the Ordinary. I just didn't want to use it because I have the Revolution skincare one, but I couldn't find it, so I just opened it up and used this one. And I've been using this one, and honestly, you guys, it burned so bad. Like I only leave this for like about 7 minutes. The max is 10, but I would only leave it to like 5 to 7 minutes because it was burning so much. Because I had so much pores, I would even open up my scab. Like I would like peel it off. Like I would grab the remover and just like take out the gunk, and then I would use that, and it was like the burning sensation. And I feel like I would never learn my lesson because I kept on doing it. And recently, the last time I did it was last week. I just did it without me plucking my pores out. I just did it, and it was like minimal burning. But this one hella burns. Hella burns. Okay, just putting it out there. So I would just basically use the Pixi toners, and I would use them as sets. So this one is a glow tonic, which I would use after I wash my face, and then I would either use the vitamin C or I would go ahead and use the retinol one. Now, I also do have serums, which when it would come with the retinol one, I would basically use all of the retinol products that I have all together because I don't really want to mix the ingredients and I don't want my skin to break out even more. So I would use basically all the retinol products together, and then I would also use all the vitamin C products together because vitamin C helps you with minimizing the color pigmentation. So I would use a vitamin C serum, then this cream, which is from Miracle Cream, and then I would also be using, where are you? Oh, I just saw it right here. The rose cold press rose oil to help with my skin. And then every morning I would go ahead and put on this sunscreen. I don't think it's the best one because it would tingle my face here and there, but I know that sunscreen is really good for your face because it helps diminish and not get the dark space, what is it called? The dark spots on your face, and lightens it up as well. And I would also use this baby right over here, which is the Mary Jane Glow. And that's basically all the products that I would use to try to help out with my skin. I know it's a lot to go by. I would definitely leave all the links down below. But best believe that I am also looking forward onto buying Paula's Choice, which is one of the most ones that is known. It's a bottle. I'm pretty sure I don't remember the name of it, but I heard it's really good to removing little bumps on your skin. I'm really nervous, but I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll keep you guys an update on my skin. It's been over a month since it has happened, and I am still waiting for some better results, but I'm glad that my skin is looking a lot better. I hope this video helped you guys a lot more, and let me know any comments down below, you guys. Any products that you would recommend to help me on reducing my skin bumps, of course. Oh my god, I would also use pore strips to like just remove it, and it's just a no-no. I'll see you guys in my next video. I hope you guys enjoy. I know I'm talking a lot. I'm really nervous. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, you guys. And thank you for coming and watching my video.